FIA Formula 2 is back. While many things have stayed the same from an unforgettable 2020 season, there are some important changes and fresh faces for this year. F2 race weekends just got even more action-packed with three races per round. Friday stayed the same with a practice session followed by a 30-minute qualifying to determine the grid for the feature race, which will now take place on Sundays and still include the mandatory pit stop. However, before then, we're treated to two sprint races on the Saturday. The starting grid for Saturday's sprint race one will be determined by reversing the top 10 finishers of Friday's qualifying, while the grid for sprint race two will be determined by reversing the top 10 finishers of sprint race one.
Therefore, it's going to be more exciting, especially for you guys. You're going to watch more racing. For us, it's going to be more challenging, and that's why it's going to be more interesting. So yeah, I hope it's going to be very nice.
The point scoring system remains the same, with 15 points awarded for a sprint race win and 25 points awarded for a feature race win.
For all of us to having three races in the weekend is going to be super busy and more intense. Especially, you know, you have to always make sure you're finishing the top 10. So the consistency, I think, is going to be one of the key points for this season in order to finish in top or on top of the championship.
Drivers can now take a haul of up to 65 points per round, up from 48 last year. 2021 sees the introduction of a new schedule too, with eight rounds stretching from March to December. A return to Monte Carlo, Baku and Yas Marina is in store for this season, alongside the new Jeddah circuit in Saudi Arabia.
I can't wait to see what the Jeddah circuit is going to be like, but Monaco and Baku is going to be awesome.
This year I'm really looking forward to race in Monaco. For sure, it's not so far from my home because I come from Cannes, south of France.
I'm pretty looking forward to Baku. I've never been there. I've only done it on F1 Sims and Sims, so it'll be quite good to go there.
I'm very looking forward to visit Saudi Arabia for the first time. I think it must be a special one, and a street circuit no less, so surely going to be an interesting one.
While many things are changing, one thing is staying the same. The Dallara F2 2018 chassis remains with the series for this year and for the following two seasons. The 18-inch rims and Pirelli tyres will remain too, as Formula 2 continues to pave the way for the new design ahead of its integration into Formula 1 next year. 50% of the field will embark on their first full season in F2. FIA Formula 3 champion Oscar Piastri switches his F3 Prema car for their F2 compatriot. Meanwhile, Formula 3 runner-up Teo Pourchaire will start his first full F2 season at just 17 years of age at the ART Grand Prix. The drivers come from 16 different countries in four different continents. Out of the 22 drivers on the grid, just under half of them have a direct link to Formula 1. Ferrari's Driver Academy boasts two drivers, Robert Schwartzman, who finished highest last year of all returning drivers, and Marcus Armstrong, who moves to Dams for 2021. Alpine's Academy features Guan Yu Zhou, Oscar Piastri and Christian Lundgaard.
So it's my second year in the Alpine Academy, formerly the Renault Sport Academy. The support was great in the first year, and looking forward to continuing that into this year as well. Obviously, the next step up from F2 is F1, so hopefully I can get stuck into the F1 team.
Red Bull promoted Yuki Tsunoda to AlphaTauri last year, and this season we'll have the pick of Yuri Vips, Jayan Dhruvala, and rookie Liam Lawson.
So I'm part of the Red Bull Junior team, and it's a big privilege for me because they've helped me a lot from my 2 years there. The experience has helped me a lot to see what Formula 1 is like and to prepare me for if I'm good enough to make the step up.
Both Williams Racing F1 drivers graduated from Formula 2, and we could see a repeat in the future, with Roy Nissany in their academy. Sauber's F2 academy comes in the shape of Teo Pourchaire. The flying Frenchman hopes to propel himself into Formula 1 with the same team that helped deliver championships with Lewis Hamilton, George Russell, Nick de Vries, Nico Rosberg, Nico Hülkenberg, and Stoffel Vandoorne. So strap in, hold on tight, because this Formula 2 season is revving up to be be one of the most exciting yet.